In this example, we are given that a rod AB of length L and mass M is hinged at the topmost point A as shown, and it is free to rotate about this point. It is saying if a ball of mass M by 2 is moving at a speed u, strikes the other end of the rod and sticks to it. We are required to find the angular speed with which rod will move after this collision. Let's first analyze the situation given here. When the ball strikes the rod, it is given that the ball sticks to the rod. And afterwards, the system will move with an angular speed, say omega, about the hinge at the position A. In this situation, initially the rod was at rest, only the ball was moving. So after collision, we can say, as no external force is acting on the system, so we can see that the angular momentum of the system will remain conserved about the point A, as net torque about point A is zero. So in this situation, we can say, as no external torque is there about A, we can state angular momentum initial must be equals to angular momentum final. So initially it is only due to the ball, which can be written as m by 2 u l. And after collision, as the system will become a single body, its angular momentum can be written as I omega, where the moment of inertia we can write as m by 2 l square plus m l square by 3 as moment of inertia of just the rod about its side axis of rotation, ml square by 3, and this is a point mass which will revolve in a circle of radius L. So its moment of inertia can be used as mr square into omega F. So using this, this mass m gets cancelled out, when L gets cancelled out. So omega final we can directly write as this will be u by 2 upon L by 2 plus L by 3. On analyzing, this will give us 5L by 6. So this we can write as 3U upon 5L. That will be the answer to this problem.